Welcome to a very brief introduction to crafting for all those among you that want to get started but feel overwhelmed by the complexity that crafting in Final Fantasy XIV is offering. First of all, you have to understand that crafting here is a complete different topic compared to crafting in other games, as you literally have rotations like you have with battle jobs, so crafting an item in high quality, especially an endgame item, will demand you to take down some crafting mechanics and use all of your discipline of the hand knowledge to get out the desired result. So to accomplish this, there are multiple stats and values that you have to know and understand. First, your crafting menu, which shows durability, progress, quality, condition, and HQ percentages. Starting with progress, which indicates that a craft is finished when completing it, so whenever you fill this bar, your craft will end and you will have the result of your work inside of your inventory. The stat quality below the progress bar, on the other hand, indicates if your item will be in normal or non-quality or in high quality. While some items like chocobo bardings or most glamour stuff don't benefit from being high quality or cannot become high quality at all. All gear that is having stats on it should always be crafted into a high quality item to gain the optimal stats and become an item that its item level is indicating. For example, only a high quality 510 item can really be seen as such. The no quality item would be way below the actual value of 510, so never use gear with stats on it that is not having this shiny symbol attached to it. The only exception is the case when you simply just want to boost your item level to accomplish the minimum item level requirements of a dungeon or raid, but note that you're turning in real value of your gear into fake value. Apart from that, while you should definitely watch Wesk Alba's more extensive video about crafting, there's one line that I have to disagree with. Every non-quality craft is a failed craft. Oh no, my friend, absolutely not. Back in Heavensward, I literally got my first 100 million gil without being able or getting myself into the topic to do real crafts. So I just crafted chocobo bardings on normal quality crafter gear, and while selling the bardings normally, I sold the crafter gear for half or less than that for the high quality price, and man, you're so wrong when considering this to be useless. Sometimes people just don't need the cool Nike shoes, but a simple Amazon Basics one may be perfectly fine for their needs. So when it comes to making profit as a crafter, never consider the foul apple to be only waste. The keen craftsman can possibly turn it into tasty apple juice. Alright, this out of the way, back to our craft menu and values. Each of these actions increasing your progress or quality bar will generally reduce your durability by 10 per action used. And when your durability is reduced to 0, your craft will end and you lose the materials unless you have a skill that is saving them. So to avoid that, always try to get your progress bar filled before reaching that 0 on durability. And without rushing into details, there are quadrillions of skills to help you out in either reducing the spend cost for your progress and quality push skills, or returning durability with other skills. So for example, on high level, just plainly crafting ingredients that you need to craft bigger things like equipment may already require a whole rotation, even when not going for a quality ingot. And if you compare the progress and quality numbers of the low level craft to the ones of the high level recipe, how the heck do we get there? Simply by increasing your disciplines of the hands level and the connected item level and stats like craftsmanship, control, and CP by earning crafter gear. Yes, you need really good and pentameled gear to achieve high quality on the highest recipes available, so it's not only leveling up your crafting job to max level, but also to get some gear for it. And when talking about your stats, craftsmanship heavily increases the power of your progress skills, while control is used for the quality department, but note that there are multiple skills serving as multipliers for this stat, so the raw number doesn't matter that much as long as you meet the requirements of the recipe shown in your crafting log. The most important stat though is CP, as this will allow you to use more special tricks and skills that will help you out in maintaining a good flow of quality and progress push, while hindering your durability to be reduced to 0. Basically all abilities other than hasty touch or basic synthesis require CP. So this really is your life's blood, and after you fulfill the recipe's control and craftsmanship requirements, you always want to go all in on CP because of having the most important value to grant you access to your crafting kit. Also know that food buffs and craftsman's tea, where you can use both together, can heavily increase your stats, especially CP value, so make use of these basically every time you're starting an intense craft, other than just quick synthesizing base materials. Which is also another option to get out a whole bunch of base materials for your leveling progress, because on endgame recipes the quick synthesis feature is not available anymore. But until you get there, you first have to level up a crafting job by doing leaf quests, Ishgard restoration, or simply crafting tons of things. So check out my leveling guide and Wesk Alba's video about crafting, or check out Zane Lionheart and Ash10 for many helpful tips about crafting in general. German viewers can also visit Charles, who is a wonderful content creator and passionate crafter as well. So thank you all for watching and stay tuned for more crafting content coming on this channel, as well as all things regarding Final Fantasy XIV. Until then, stay safe, stay healthy, and keep loving Final Fantasy.